When you get to this slide in the Nearpod, it's going to be time to now go up and work in our Monday, August 31st workbook up here. So I'm just going to go over and I'm going to start modeling what that's going to look like and how you're going to complete that assignment today. So once you get to this side, we're going to go over to the workbook. And what you're going to see are 20 different parts of spending that we see in our lives very, very routinely. And your first goal is to sort all of those into a fixed expense, which means that it will be the same every month, or a variable expense, which means that it's going to change from month to month depending on how you're living your life. Now, a lot of these, I want you answering these questions if it's fixed or variable based on your own brain. There's a little bit of interpretation up here where it's okay if you don't have the same exact answers as everyone else because we all have different lives. So I'm going to go over here and click on housing/rent, and you should see the little blue box highlighted around it so you know you've clicked on it. Now, housing/rent for me is usually a fixed expense. I have the same exact mortgage payment every single month and that number doesn't change. So that's going to be fixed instead of variable. So I'm going to make sure I'm clicked on housing/rent. I'm going to hit Control X to cut it. Then I'm going to scroll down and I'm either going to put it in the fixed part of the chart or the variable expense. I just said it was fixed. So I'm going to click down in the chart here and hit Control V. And boom, housing rent will go under a fixed expense. I'm going to go back up here. Utilities, electric, water, and gas. For me, that's variable based on how much the heater was running that month, how many showers that I took, how much I cooked. Utilities, they're usually really, really similar, but they're always a little bit different. So since they change, that means it's variable. So I'm going to once again click on it so I see the blue box. Control X cuts it. And now I'm going to click under the variable part. And Control V will paste it there. And you're going to continue doing that for all 20 of these. And that's the only work you're going to do in the workbook for today.